There were strong winds buffeting the island of Sodor. They'd only gotten worse over time. One morning, Sir Topham Hatt was enjoying his breakfast when his wife came in and told him that some slates had been blown off the roof during the night.
"I'll get someone to repair them soon, dear," he said. "It's no good trying to repair them in this gale."
Meanwhile, at the sheds, the other engines were busy teasing James. The last time they'd had a strong wind like this, he'd been spun around on a turntable until he'd been quite giddy.
"Be careful, James," Henry warned. "Mind you don't go on any turntables today."
James was cross.
"Make sure you don't stick in a tunnel to avoid the wind," he retorted.
But Henry didn't care. He and the other engines set off to work. Henry's first stop was before the viaduct.
"Be careful, Henry," said the station master. "The wind on the viaduct is very fierce today. Don't let it beat you."
But Henry was lucky. The wind had dropped for a few moments at the right time. He brought his train safely over with no mishaps.
"Well done, Henry," said his driver. "Off we go."
"That's one in the headlamp for old James," Henry chortled.
The station beyond was in an exposed area, too. Henry knew this, but he was so pleased at crossing the viaduct safely that he had forgotten.
"Fancy, all this fuss over a bit of wind," he said cheerfully. "I've no more stops until the workstation. I'll show James who's best at running in wind."
But as he rattled through the station, he saw something that made him whistle with horror. 100 yards in front, a large tree had been uprooted and came crashing down in front of him, blocking the line.
"Oh!" groaned Henry.
His driver applied the brakes, and they skidded along the line towards the tree. Nothing happened. Henry opened his eyes. He found that he'd stopped 6 inches from the fallen tree. He let out a sigh of steam with relief as the conductor ran up to see what the matter was. Henry pushed the coaches back to the station platform, very shaken. But the passengers got out and cheered for him, as he had prevented a nasty accident. That night, James visited Henry in the yard.
"Well done, Henry," he said. "Perhaps it's useful to stick when you need to, after all."
The winds continued to be a problem for some time, with many more trees being blown down across the line. Henry and the other engines were kept very busy clearing them away and making repairs. But soon, the engines were putting up more trees, and Terence and Trevor helped to move them where they needed to go.
"We'll make sure to plant them far enough from the lines or they aren't as big a problem," Terence called to Henry.
Henry was very pleased. Soon the new trees were growing strong and tall, but they were a safe distance from the line. So even as the winds continued, Henry knew he wouldn't have to worry about... as much about trees falling again.